Hi friends, good morning. How are you? In the last class, I explained about the relative atomic mass and number of atoms. Am I correct? Is it clear or not? Okay. Today we can see about the gram atomic mass and Avogadro number. You know that the atomic mass or some of the elements I show you in the last class, that is atomic mass of hydrogen atom 1, helium 4, nitrogen 14, oxygen 16, then sodium 23 and all. Is it clear? Then what do you mean by this gram atomic mass? From the word itself, it is clear that the atomic mass expressed in grams is called the gram atomic mass, or the mass of an element expressed in grams that is equal to the atomic mass is gram atomic mass. Then we can see some of the atomic masses of some elements. See this one. Hydrogen 1, helium 4, carbon 12, nitrogen 14, oxygen 16, sodium 23, sulfur 32, potassium 39, phosphorus 31, and chlorine 35.5, calcium 40, and iron 56. These are the atomic masses of some of the important elements. You should learn these, at least this much elements atomic mass. Is it clear? This is needed for the problems and the calculations. Is it clear? If you know this one only, you can calculate or you can do the problems. Some of the problems are there in the next page. So you have to learn these atomic masses of elements. Then what do you mean by this gram atomic mass? The mass of an element in grams equal to its atomic mass is called 1 gram atomic mass, and it is shortened as 1 gam of atom. 1 gam, that means 1 gram atomic mass. Then mass of some elements, atomic mass, mass in grams and gam and number of atoms of some of the elements are given here in the table. You have to learn this one also for doing the problems. Then see this one, the element carbon. Carbon atomic mass 12. Then mass in grams 12 gram. Atomic mass expressed in gram. Then that means 1 gam. And what is the number of atoms in that element? That is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23. Then for oxygen atom, atomic mass is 16. And mass in grams 16 grams. That is equal to 1 gam. That is also equal to number of atoms 6.022 into 10 raised to 23. For nitrogen atom, it is atomic mass 14, then mass in grams 14 gram, then that is equal to 1 gam, and that is equal to number of atoms same. Then for chlorine atom, the atomic mass is 35.5 and the mass in grams is 35.5 gram, and which is equal to 1 gam, and at the same time the number of atoms also same. Then 1 gram atomic mass of any element contains 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 atoms. Clear or not? See, in all the elements the number of atoms is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 atoms. This number is named as Avogadro number. What do you mean by this? Avogadro number. So 1 gram atomic mass of any element contains 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 atoms. This number is known as Avogadro number and is denoted as Na. A is little bit down of this N, that is written like that. So Avogadro number, that means 1 gram atomic mass of any element. See that in all the elements, the number of atoms same, contains 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 atoms. This number is known as Avogadro number and is denoted as Na. See this one. You have to be very clear about this one. These terms are very important ones. The number of gram atomic mass. How can we calculate the number of gram atomic mass? That is equal to given mass divided by gam of the element. Gam means gram atomic mass. You have to be very clear that one. Given mass divided by gam of element. Then how many? I'll give you one problem.
listen all of you. How many GAM is present in 69 gram of sodium? Then how many atoms present in it? Appo sodium is given here. The given mass is 69 gram. And how can we calculate the number of GAM? GAM means gram atomic mass. So atomic mass of sodium is 23. You have already learned atomic mass of sodium is 23. So how can we calculate this? Given mass divided by GAM. What is given mass? 69 gram. Is it clear? Then GAM of the element, GAM of sodium is 23. Then 69 divided by 23, that is equal to 3 gram. So number of GAM is equal to 3 grams. Then how can we calculate the number of atoms? Number of atoms is equal to number of GAM into Na, that is 3 into Na. Na is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23. Then 3 into 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 is the number of atoms. Is it clear or not? Then some of the problems, the one or two problems are given in the same page itself, page number 41. You have to do it as homework. Is it clear or not? I'll tell you once again. How can we calculate the gram atomic mass of the given element? That is equal to given mass divided by GAM of the element. GAM is a gram atomic mass. So how can we calculate? Here sodium is given. Its given mass is 69 gram. And atomic mass of sodium is 23. So 69 divided by 23 is equal to 3 gram. What about the number of atoms present in that? That is 3 into Na. Is it clear or not? So you have to do that problem 1 and 2 in the page number 41 as homework after this one. After I am giving the notes. Okay. Then what do you mean by 1 mole of atom? After the 1 mole of atom. 1 mole of atom means 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 atoms. 1 mole of atom, that is equal to 6.022 into 10 raised to 23. You have to see the textbook, read the textbook carefully in these pages. Then, for example, 12 gram of carbon is equal to 1 GaM. Its atomic mass, the atomic mass of carbon is 12 gram. So, that is equal to 1 GaM of carbon, which is equal to 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 atoms, and which is same as 1 mole carbon atom. Is it clear or not? So what do you mean by this 1 mole of atom? 1 mole of atom means 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 atoms, which is equal to Avogadro number, which is named as Avogadro number. This and it is denoted as Na. Is it clear or not? So 1 mole of atom. And so this can be written as 12 gram of carbon can be written as in these ways, that is equal to 1 GaM of carbon, and which is equal to 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 atoms, and which is equal to 1 mole of carbon atom. Is it clear? Okay, thank you.